Hey there, welcome to Things Dan's Way. So in a previous video, I built a power system for my RV that used three of these 100 amp hour OKMO batteries and an inverter and a solar charger, and basically made the trailer an off-grid little cabin. The beauty is that thing can run for infinitely long, as long as I don't use up the power that I captured during the day with solar panels. And the reality is I have 36 solar panels on the roof, and yet I don't have a backup system that uses that solar to actually make my home work when the power goes down. And here in California, with brownouts and other issues, wildfires, you name it, power outages are a thing. And so, okay, so let me build a system similar to that one that'll power the critical loads in my home. So I've gathered some parts here. If you wanna watch me put together a system, the power goes out, you can have your fridge and your freezer and internet and the basic things working in your home. Don't go away. This is Doing Things Dan's Way. So for me, the basic functionality I'm looking for is that when the power goes out, the circuits in my kitchen, which basically include just the lights and the fridge and the freezer in the garage and the internet, stays alive. Ultimately, that's only a few hundred watts of power. A fridge is honestly 150 watts, 200 watts. So all I need is maybe 1,000 or 1,500 watts max, and a system would do those critical loads and then other lights and other things as needed. So ultimately, the big piece of the puzzle here are the batteries. I have four of these OKMO 100 amp hour, 12 volt batteries I purchased. And these ones are, they're light for what they are. They're, you know, they're like 24 pounds. And I can just stack these up on a shelf and wire them together in series and parallel and give myself power. So the power from these four, which all told is just shy of 5,000 watts for an hour, or 1,000 watts for 5 hours. You know, that's kind of how to think of it. That power will be routed to an inverter. So this is a 1,500 watt true sine inverter that also has a charger function and also will take in solar. So those are all capabilities of this. This also has kind of a UPS ability. So this cord here will be plugged in to mains power and be routed to the outputs here at all times, unless the power fails. So as soon as the power fails, suddenly this thing will switch into taking the power from the batteries and delivering power out. This is kind of the heart of it. This is the power to it. And then for recharge purposes, I have one of these 30 amp chargers. So this will do 750 watts into a 24 volt array, which is how this inverter will be, these batteries and this inverter will be wired. And so this will give me 750 watts with the panels operating at peak efficiency. So that is much better than a PWM. So this is MPPT, maximum power point tracking, versus a PWM, which is basically connect the panels straight to the battery voltage. Now the other piece of this is, okay, once I have a power system like this wired up, how do we get this power into the circuits in the home? And that's what I'll show you next with this 6-channel transfer switch. Okay, so over here in the corner of my garage, this is where I have kind of my solar inverters. This is the back of my power panel. And so let's zoom in here a little bit and I'll show you the transfer switch that I have, how it works, and how I plan to plug into the power system that I'm going to build right here on this shelf. Okay, over here tucked in the corner, this is a 6-channel transfer switch. And so basically what this does is it takes the output from six of the breakers in my main panel, so the output lead after the breaker, it takes it, kind of hijacks it, runs it down this line here and into this box. So when the switch is in the down position, where it says line right here, that means the power is basically just gonna go down through the breaker, through the switch, and then out to the load. And that's just like status quo. So right now, all these switches are down because the utility is powering my home. Now, if I want to flip the switch to the up position, what it's gonna do is it's gonna take the power coming from this wire here, whatever's feeding this is gonna go through that channel, an individual channel, and power that part of the home individually. So the other end of this is most of the time hooked up to a portable battery that I have, a nice Goal Zero unit. And in the case of a power outage, we come out, we turn on the Goal Zero unit's output, the 120 volts there, we come over here and then we flip however many of these circuits we wanna have go live. And so this is the garage, this is the kitchen, the label fell off, this is the kitchen, the furnace and a few circuits and lights around that part of the home, the master bedroom lights, my wife's office and my office. And so in my office, we have like the internet type connected to it. So we can go through and flip all these circuits, and we will have basically most of the lights in the house. Certainly not all the outlets by any means, but the lighting circuits are all tied to these. The kitchen, not appliances like the wall outlets or the microwave, that sort of thing. Just the lights and the fridge are on the kitchen circuit. And so we wouldn't be able to like use a microwave. We wouldn't be able to use the stove, that sort of thing. And so the plan would be, let's take this and plug this system into the inverter that I was just showing you a minute ago, and have that inverter power, these circuits. So because this inverter requires 24 volts on the input, and these are 12 volt batteries, we're gonna be wiring two of these batteries in series. So it's gonna be like minus, plus, minus, plus. So between here and here, if I put a jumper on like this, if I measure this, it'll be 24 volts. So if I do the same thing on these other two and call that 24 volts, and then wire the two pluses and the two minuses together, so it's still 24 volts, but twice as much total power, that's how it'll be wired. So it'll be two in series and two in parallel, or 2S, 2P. So that's the battery arrangement that we'll need to wire it over on the shelf here. So the wiring for the solar panels is pretty simple. This unit here will take in up to 100 volts total voltage and drop that down to the 12 volts at higher current as needed, and also do the proper charge profile. So that's just power into from the panels, and then there's connections that go out to the batteries. So power in, power out. Okay, let's figure out how to do this series parallel combination with these batteries. Okay, that's pretty simple. That's giving me 24 volts here and 24 volts here. You have this little crisscross happening here, and then you draw power from there to there up to the inverter. That feels like the shortest total path. So the wire I'm using here is zero gauge copper, so 1-aught. The beauty of running an inverter at 24 volts instead of 12 is the current is half because the voltage is double. So this wire won't see more than 100 amps. Now I just need to build jumper from there to there and jumper from here to there. These are really not the right tool for this. As always, of course, I'll put links down below to all this stuff in case you want to duplicate any of this. And this is how I like to do these. Just push down and walk it around. And then I'm also, as you're doing that, you're actually able to see the copper down inside and see if you cut like all the way through or not. If you saw my previous video, I received a battery that had been smashed a little bit open, and all it basically did is it broke the glue holding on part of the lid, and so I broke it the rest of the way off so I could see inside. So I'll show you that right here. Okay, and then once I get them out, you just gotta be careful to get all of the strands inside like that. So this is a spring-loaded, like little swaging device where you put it all together like that. You get this lined up right on the center point of the where you want the crimp to be, and then you smack it with a hammer. So that third and fourth whack, you could hear the tone change. And that just kind of tells you, okay, you've gone all the way through, and now it's solid metal from the top of the hammer, through the device, through the copper, and then down to the ground. That gives us a very clean path. And the kit that I got that with, as well as the ends, even comes with the heat shrink, so... No, I can't turn it around or I'll get cooked. Okay, so at this point I have all the crossovers and everything built. As soon as I close one of these, then this will be 24 volts, and this 24 volts will go and feed the inverter. And likewise, if I short this out, then this 24 volts is going to go and feed the inverter. People are always scared about the spark that happens there, and so I'm just gonna show a quick way to get around that. So by using a high power resistor like this, you're just gonna touch these two together, and there's no spark or anything because the 10 ohms reduces the current down to almost, a real small value. So once you touch them together for a couple seconds, the caps are gonna be fully charged inside the inverter, and you're just gonna take it and touch it, and you get no spark. And I wanna make sure these leads are tight. And there's already 24 volts on this, and so I can go ahead and touch this here. Something I should have said before doing any of this work on the batteries in terms of paralleling them is to go through and fully charge all of the batteries. You want the batteries to be at the same state of charge before you start. But okay, at this point, we can go ahead and turn it on. This is a 1500 watt heater, so it's gonna put this battery or this inverter right up to its max.
Okay, so this is showing the battery's fine, full power. And the load is at 100%. This thing's pushing out a lot of good heat. And if I just go into just fan mode, okay, now it's just the fan, so it's really low. And again, we're showing just one bar there. Okay, so we are delivering 1500 watts, no problem. I've checked all the voltages, everything looks fine. I'll put links, of course, to everything down in the description below, and I'll put some actual quotes over here on how much things are really costing as of today. On Amazon. These batteries are roughly, with after discounts or coupon codes, that sort of thing, you can get these batteries for about $170 a piece. So that's what, $340, so $680 in the batteries that's here. You can get an inverter like this with that transfer switch UPS function, adds a little bit more cost. You can get these for about $300. This one I've had for a number of years. This was my first off-grid system way back in the day when I was powering my office with four solar panels on the roof. And then finally, the piece here would be the solar charger. And these solar chargers are running about this much. I think they're about $90, but the price is up here, the real price, and the Amazon listing will be, of course, listed. A couple other accessories like the, you know, the crimper, the wire set, a couple other pieces, the fuse block. That's kind of all the pieces that are here. Oh, and then the transfer switch. Those can run a little bit more expensive. Those are around $200 to $300, depending on how many circuits you connect to it. The other thing about that transfer switch that I didn't maybe point out before is because whatever power is connected to it is what goes to the circuits in the house, it's incredibly easy to go from, you know, running on batteries like this to just a regular generator. So if it's, you know, a cloudy, dark day and I burn through these batteries, I can always just pull out my generator that I have, fire it up, and I can run indefinitely on gasoline, you know, with the generator. So that's always an option. This is more of that system that will just automatically function. My wife can come out and flip the other switches to make the rest of the house light up. Kind of that simple. That's kind of where it's at today with the portable generator as well. So anyway, that's the kind of system. Let's go ahead and tear this down and build it over on that shelf and see it all when it's basically done. That will probably just be a build montage.
Okay, so while this build montage moves on, I just want to say that there is a long version of this video that has a lot more content and shows the build process in much greater detail. I mean, I literally had hours of content on this video I couldn't show. So you can hit that in the description below. Okay, let's talk through all the pieces of the system as it exists here on the wall. So we start off with the four batteries. The four batteries are connected in series, so that goes from ground up to 24 volts and ground up to 24 volts. These two jumper wires are what are giving us the combination of the two batteries coming together. And then what I just now added is the Renogy current shunt. So this current shunt is giving us the measurement of all the current that comes and goes from the batteries. And the solar comes in on this side, which is the load side of the shunt. So that when the solar is pushing power into the battery, it's going through this path to the battery this way. And when we're drawing power out of the batteries, it's coming out this way. Okay, so this is the Renogy display. I'll program this to the total amp hours that are here, which is gonna be 400 amp hours. But this shows voltage, it shows the currents coming and going from the batteries, the wattage. It also says how long in the current load the battery will last, as well as while you're charging, how long it's going to take to charge up. So it's kind of gives you lots of good information all on one nice display, and all with just this piece and the current shunt. So on the back side of the shelf, there is the inverter that's mounted upside down to the back of the shelf. And that's these two leads here going up to the inverter. The other piece of this puzzle is the solar charger. So solar comes down the wall, goes up and into these contacts here. And then the output is what's going down to the battery like that. And this display tells us, again, voltages and currents, what the solar is doing, what the power is doing, all those things. So at this point, let me go ahead and cover this all up so I can safely put the shelf in without shorting anything out. Okay, guys, that is a wrap. The system is fully installed. The solar charger is working. The Renogy monitor is active. The inverter is running and it's using and it's powering my kitchen right now. I'm gonna let it just run it continuously and see if the two panels up on the roof are enough to keep the kitchen running. We'll see. And that's just lights and fridge, by the way. I just kind of stockpiled all my other portable battery solutions down here, the ones I built and the ones I bought. And so let me know in the comments below, is this something you would do? Are you interested in building something like this? Or is an all-in-one the right way to go for you? I comment back on everyone's comments. So if you're interested in doing that, hit it up. Hit these videos here for other generator type projects that I have done. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you want to see the next content like this come out. Until next time, guys, just know that no matter who you are and what you've done, God loves you and you're blessed.